Since pictures are worth a million words, and they're going to be especially useful in predicting outcomes, I'm going to ask you to take an equation, a linear equation, and come up with the picture of it, which would be a line. Do you remember when I told you that if we took all the points that fit into an equation, or that were the solution to an equation, here are four of them, and plotted them, do you remember what happens? Let's plot 4, 5, over 4 and up 5, 1, negative 1, over 1 and down 1, 1.50. I'm going to go over 1.5 squares and up none. See that? Over 1.5 squares and up no squares. And 2, 1. Go over 2 and up 1. Now, they're spread out differently, but one thing's for sure. If I did other points, they all line up. Every pair that fits into this equation, that is a solution to this equation, is on that line. And in fact, that line goes on how far?
To infinity and beyond.
It goes on forever. So you can predict the future almost of this equation, which can represent some very useful things in life, with a drawing of the line. Now, if you're trying to find that line, all you really need is 2 points. Now, here's these points. I want to demonstrate something to you.
Well, isn't that special?
It doesn't matter which 2 points I pick. If I picked these 2, and I didn't even pay attention to the other 2, I'd know where the line is, wouldn't I? What if I picked these 2? Same line. What if I pick these 2? It doesn't matter.
Oh, no.
I really only need 2 points. I'm going to tell you to do 3, though. Okay? So here's the kind of problem I'm going to give you. Graph this line. Draw the line that represents this equation.
Wait a minute.
I know there's an infinite amount of points on the line.
Phew.
And I know you only need 2.
But
as I said, I'm going to ask you to find 3 of them. And I'm going to ask you to make a chart. Now you get to pick any numbers to put in. And I suggest that you put them in for x. So let's make them easy numbers. The easiest number I know is 0. So I always use 0. I put in 0 for x. And nicely, I can find y. Let's see, y equals 2 times 0, which is 0, minus 1, so 0 minus 1. In this case, y is negative 1. So the pair 0, negative 1 is a solution, and I'll graph it. I'll go over none and down 1. Now I need at least 1 more. What's the next easiest number you can think of? Let's put in 1. Put in 1 for x. 2 times 1 is 2, minus 1, ends up in this case, y comes out 1. So I have the pair 1, 1. So start at the origin, go over 1 and up 1, and you've got the point. Now you probably already know where the line is, but I always tell people to do one more point. And the next easiest one I know, it doesn't matter, but we're going to use the next easiest number is 2. 2 times 2 is 4, and 4 minus 1 is 3. Y is 3. So let's start at the origin, go over 2, and up 3. Now before we do it, let's pray that they line up. And I can see that they do. The reason I have you do 3 points and not 2 is if you do 3 and they don't line up, you can see that you know when you made a mistake. So always do 3 points, and if they line up, like this, you know you have the right answers. Now, you have the, we still need the line, and what do?
To infinity and beyond!
You connect them and add the arrows, and we know where the line is.
Thank you, Simon! Have another!
Let's do another one. I hope you noticed in the last one that it was way easier to find Y if we began by getting Y by itself, and I'm going to tell you to always do that.
Hello.
You're going to make your chart and begin by solving for Y first. Did you see that my 4X is keeping Y from being alone? So I'll subtract 4X from both sides. And I'll get 8 minus 4x. Now, who's keeping y from being alone? 2. So I'll divide by 2. Everybody. And I'll get y equals 4 minus 2x. Now, it's going to be much easier that way, and there's going to be way more reasons in the future for solving for y. So get used to, for cripe's sake, solve for y. Now, we're back to the same old way. Put in various numbers for x. Let's put in the three easiest I know. 0. 4 minus 2 times 0 is 4 minus 0, or 4. And I have the pair 0, 4. Go over 0 and up 4. What's the next number I should put in? Let's make life easy. I'll put in a 1 for x. And 4 minus 2 times 1 is 4 minus 2, or 2. So in this case, I've got the pair 1 for x and 2 for y. So I go over 1 and up 2. I ask you to do 3 points, remember, so you can check your errors if you make one. So we'll put in...
What a maroon! What an ignoramus!
For cripe's sake, put in easy numbers, knucklehead! We could put in negative 87, but we can also slap ourselves in the face. Let's put in an easy number like 2. And let's see, 4 minus 2 times 2, or 4 minus 4, we're going to get 0. 0 can be an answer. So I'm going to graph the pair 2, 0 by going over 2 and up none. I'm very happy about this, aren't I? Because
to infinity
they line up.
And beyond.
I draw the line and put on the arrows, and I have the graph, if you would, of this linear equation. And I got a tough one for you. See if you can do it. We're going to graph this equation. Remember how to do it. How do we begin? Always begin. You're going to be glad in the future if you did that. Now let's look at who's keeping y from being alone. There's a minus 2x and a 3. Let's begin by adding 2x to both sides. Now I'm going to divide everybody by 3. Be careful. I've got to do it to everybody. On the left side, we just get y. On the right side, we have 3 over 3, which is 1, and 2 over 3, which is 2 over 3. And it doesn't come out nice. You get a fraction. But I have a fix for that. That's why I wanted to do this example. Usually, we've been putting in the three easiest numbers that we know, 0, 1, and 2.
Now what am I going to do?
Well, we want to make life easy. You can put in anything you want. No, instead of putting 0, 1, and 2, let's put in...
Pay attention, son. This is for your own good.
Yeah, this is going to make life easier. Put in multiples of the denominator, which is, in this case, 3. So we're going to put in multiples of 3, and it's going to come out much nicer.
Oh, my God!
Watch. I'm going to put in 0. And, of course, that'll cancel. 2 times 0 is 0. And I get a 1. That's easy. Go over 0 and up 1. Now let's put in 3. That's a multiple of 3. Look, the 3's cancel. That's why I put in a 3. And I'm left with 1 plus 2. That's a nice easy number. And I'll graph that. Go over 3 and up 3. And now let's put in, I could put in 6 also, but I chose to put in negative 3. Now the 3's are going to cancel, but the negative isn't. And I'm going to have a negative 2 plus 1, which is a negative 1. Now can you graph that point? Basically, we're going to go back 3 and down 1. Back 3 and down 1. And son of a gun, they line up.
Yeah, baby. Yeah.
And all you have to do is draw the line.
To infinity and beyond.
And put the arrows on it. Okay? So make sure if you have a fraction, use multiples of the denominator. It'll make life way easier for you. This one's a little bit different, but it still follows. Sometimes things are so easy they're hard. Still follows our rules. What's your first step? Get used to that. Who's keeping Y from being alone? The 3. He's multiplying. So I'll divide. So in this case, Y equals 2. Now, as I said, sometimes things are so easy, they're hard. There's no fraction here, so I don't need multiples of anybody. I'm going to put in the 3 easiest numbers I know for X.
No!
What is the 3 easiest numbers? 0, 1, and 2. Not so bad. The problem here is there isn't an X to put in for. But remember what we're trying to get here. We're trying to get the Y coordinate. So in the first point, what is Y? What is Y gonna, well, told you right there. Y is 2. I told you it's so easy it's hard. Y is 2. Didn't even have to put it in. If we graph that point, we get over none and up 2. In the second point, guess what Y is? Told you Y is 2. Go over 1 and up 2. In the third point, what is Y? Y is, you got it, Y is 2. And nicely, if we graph 2, 2, go over 2 and up 2, you're going to feel a lot better.
You are correct, sir.
They line up. This is called a constant function. It's constantly 2. But son of a gun, it is a linear function.
To infinity and beyond.
Isn't it? It forms a line. Every time, Y is 2. Now the solve for Y method is going to work the vast majority of the times. There is one situation when it won't work, and I'd like you to see that.
Houston, we have a problem.
In this case, what did I ask you to begin with? But there isn't a Y. So, what do we do? Well, you don't have to be a brain surgeon to know. We don't have any other choice, bub, right? So we'll solve for X. But normally, we're going to try to solve for Y. There isn't a Y, so we'll solve for X. Who's keeping the X from being alone? The 2. So I'll divide by 2. And I'll get X is minus 1. Now, as I said, this one's a little bit weird, but not difficult. What do we put in for X? Be careful here. What are we going to put in for X in our 3 points? Well, read the equation. X has got to be negative 1. They said it was negative 1. They didn't say anything about Y. Since they didn't say anything about Y, Y can be anything. And I get to pick Y. I pick the easiest number, 0. If I graph negative 1, 0, back 1 and up none, it goes there. Now you got to pick the first point's Y. What are you going to pick for the second point's Y? Pick anything you want. Pick the next easiest number, 1. Go back 1 and up 1. Starting to line up here. And the third point, no fraction, so let's do 2. Go back 1 and up 2. I'm feeling pretty good. They're lining up.
To infinity and beyond.
And if I draw it, it's okay.
Oh, I can't take it anymore.
Okay, well, go practice. Do your homework.